Okay, so this is episode 20 of the world tour. I've made a little change as far as the webcam shot here, so it's hopefully a little bit better. And we're going to take off from Brevig Mission, and we're going to head to Provideniya Bay in Russia. So that's basically the only spot I could find in the area. So looks good. I think we're ready to take off. So fasten your seatbelts. I think we're about ready to depart straight
out. Papa Foxtrot Kilo Tango Traffic Grim Tours Golf
and
Romeo.
We'll start the stopwatch, and it's going to be mostly ocean. So it is what it is. And I'm going to put the keyboard in. Scoot up here. Okay, we're gonna take the brakes off. I have my feet on the brakes. Okay, and let the engine get up to speed. All right, we'll do this. Look at that. Okay, here we're fine. So once we get some airspeed here, once we get some speed, start. Takes off by itself. Once you hit 100 miles an hour, it takes off by itself. Who knew? The weather looks like it's going to be this mostly, but the worst part is it's going to be mostly ocean. So the choice is clouds or ocean as far as what we see. And I guess we'll do about here, I guess. So let's not turn up so much. Turn. Back on course here. So 182 miles. Should be just over an hour. So this is 76 minutes. And I guess I don't understand that. It says 76 feet 1 inches as no time to arrival. Right, so let's trim down so we're even out a little bit. And there we go. We gain some speed here. Start flying. So hopefully we'll have some people viewing this Brevig mission as we left. So hopefully we'll have some people chatting. Otherwise it's gonna be fairly, I don't want to say boring, it's not gonna be boring, it's a beautiful flight. But it's gonna be most uneventful, I'd like to say. Should be good. You always want to get to your destination uneventfully. I'm not sure how much I like the camera in portrait mode here, so I would like your take on that. If you like it, hit that like button. If you don't, hit that like button. But leave a comment. Tell me why you don't like it. But yeah, if you like watching flight sim stuff, I have a full playlist on YouTube. YouTube.com/watchyourgrim. And you watch all of my previous world tour flights to where we got to Alaska and into Russia here. And that's all there. I have other previous flights and stuff that you can watch. That's all there for the consumption. If you like that stuff and you like watching me in general, you can hit the subscribe subscribe button there on YouTube. And if you're watching on Twitch, you can do me a follow, and that will help me out here get some viewers. Should get me a little bit higher on the rankings, I suppose. No, I'm not sure exactly how that works. But yeah, if you are on Twitch and you're watching right now and you want to come hang out, say something, you know, like I said, it's going to be a pretty eventless flight, so Twitch interaction would be nice to have if you're here and you want to chat and say hi. Not even touching the controls, it's all gaining a little bit of altitude. Speed's pretty steady. There's like no wind apparently. But yeah, it's our choice of what we're gonna look at here is pretty much clouds or ocean. I can definitely hang out around the ocean. I can definitely hang out around the clouds. So it just depends on where we want to go for the next hour. Just a calm, chill flight where we hang out. Storms out in the distance. Negative 8 degrees Celsius outside. It's pretty cold. It's weird how... You know, it's weird how cold it is, because realistically, this is probably about the right temperature, 9,000 feet up. And is the Arctic Circle? I don't know if it's the Arctic Circle. I assume it's somewhat the Arctic Circle. It is, and knowing that, you know, this is pretty realistic, and yet, you know, in Southern California right now, it's 111 degrees, and they just sent a warning out telling us to turn off our air conditioner so we can suffer. start at 7 o'clock. Let's go ahead and get everything kind of getting backed up. I help. But I also have solar panels that pumps electricity into the grid pretty much all day. Running into a little bit of wind. About an hour away, but we'll start doing some speedy runs here
shortly.
Forward on the flight stick and try not to climb anymore. And we're going about 180 miles an hour, so we should start hearing warning sounds once we hit 200. We're about 200. So our true airspeed, you know, it starts warning us after 195 apparently. But as long as our airspeed, measured airspeed, does not go over 200, we should be fine. I don't know if we'll actually experience any issues if we do. But yeah. Our true airspeed, we can go, you know, go over 200. Clouds and ocean now. Do this for the next. So we're 137 miles away, we're going 208 miles an hour. Gaining speed. So. Rate of speed up and get us to the destination quicker. 20, you don't hit that big blue thing. The bottom big blue thing or the top big blue thing? It's difficult to hit the top blue, big blue thing. About 45 minutes to go, which is interesting. Yeah, that's not. Looks like it should be that long. It's weird how it is that long. Minutes. There you go. We I didn't really expect too far off from that. So that would put us at 61 minutes, so an hour and a minute or so. So we're staying at that speed instead of slowing down here like we are. But that's not that bad. To their nap. I could have just gone for a nap instead. How about a switch fuel? Should I switch my tanks? I think I should switch my tanks. Even it out a little bit. I think that's why we're pushing one side. Time and distance. Speed, distance. Time calculator for $4. Really? Jeez. Conversion. Sure, that's great. This one's gonna be perfect since it's free and I don't have any admin at all. Cool. I'm sure this one's great. Don't track me. Oh, I gotta do another vid. Okay, great. Like I said, no, there's gotta be no ads to this, right? Okay, minutes. Calculate minutes. Nope. Nope, this is terrible. This is... You're watching some guy go through an app on the App Store. This is terrible. I would like a refund, please. I would like this to not be in my list ever. I don't like that about Apple, is that the apps in your app list. If you've installed an app, guess what? That app is yours forever. Flight distance calculator. I just want to do. I just want to calculate it. Okay. Quickly converts. Arrival, turn. Is there a way I can trim the... I mean, I know there isn't. The only way to do that is by evening that out. Unless there's wind. Maybe we've got a lot of wind. There's not an app. Doing that simple distance and speed calculation. Distance, speed. Time, speed, distance. Okay, there is a time, speed, distance calculator. It's very simple. So hopefully there's no ads. Perfect. There we go. Okay. Our miles are 89, and we're going at 73. We've got 26 minutes. Now, it'd be nice if it, like, started the countdown. but 26 minutes, that seems like we've lost a lot of time. To speed. So... see if we can gain some altitude. And we have been gaining some altitude today, so we have lost a lot of time and speed. Let's see if we can get it. Get some altitude really quick. Speed doesn't go below like 100. We'll be alright. Maybe zoom out a little bit. Should be able to gain some speed back here. 150. Tight this time, so we can climb at a better pace without losing as much speed. To try and go around these clouds to the south here. through them. You know, it matters. Why are we climbing much? So 57-minute flight, you know, just under an hour. That's right. Cool. Okay. So as we come into Russia and we get on air traffic control, another just one of those things that that can break the region of the camera is that the air traffic control it doesn't even have a lick of an accent. So you know, it's just it's the way it is in the game. That, yeah, it'd be, I think it would give a little bit of immersion, a little bit more immersion if, yeah, you're coming into Russia and they had a Russian accent. And, you know, Microsoft does have different languages, it has different voices, it has different accents. It can easily do accents based on even just general location. You know, they could have Northern Russia accents versus Southern Russian accents. I don't know if I could tell a difference, but Microsoft has that technology. It's in their voice synthesis software. It's in their models that they could use just for flight sim. We're going over 195 miles an hour, so you got the alarm in the background. That's okay. You want to speed to get through this though. That looked really weird. This cloud has it formed. You got close. Now look inside the cockpit. Looks daunting. I lost speed. Go down again. Disappearing the clouds. Yeah. It definitely looks. It looks nice. About this altitude. Try not to slow down too much. 65 miles away, it's not too bad. So we're about 15 minutes. Altitude. monitor speed, make sure that I drop below 10. Alright, 12,000 feet. 140 miles an hour. Yeah. You see the land right there, we're 50 miles away. I can't even pronounce any of these locations if I have them on a map, so pretty much I shouldn't even try. Alright, so let's trim up so that we're not sending too fast. Turn that down so we can start a second. Alright, we're 190 miles an hour with 47, 12 minutes. And of course, we go 197. Miles an hour. We're gonna hit some inner speed. Slow down a little bit. We're almost there to our destination. What's on the airport list? Provideniya Bay. We'll take the tower, yeah. And we'll request a full stop on the
tower. Grim Tours Golf Romeo 666. 1 mile east, 8,300 feet to land.
So I don't think that's necessarily close to 30 miles. one to us at 1,046 feet in our pattern entry. We're flying fine here. Looks like controlled airspace. I assume the blue lined mark is controlled airspace. We're doing all right coming into Provideniya Bay. Yeah, if you're watching and pronouncing it wrong, feel free to correct me and let me know how to pronounce it. Because I'm sure a lot of these locations, as I butcher them horribly.
We're getting pretty close. Actually, I'm gonna
as we start going in here. Okay, the wind is actually fine right now. What's our altitude? 52. 51. 50. Just got to keep an eye on that. No, we can see the ocean, so we're fine as far as... See, we have some mountains in the way. Go down too much further. Boy oh boy, I don't know exactly what to do here. Flying on altitude. We've got some hills to go over. We're getting some wind over these hills. We're 5 miles from our pattern entry there, and we've got these freaking hills that are, you know, what, 2,000 feet, 3,000 feet up? Just gnarly. Do I see some trees now? Do I see some trees? Okay, so I'm not going to go to that actual entry point. We're just going to turn in here because we're turning, like I said, we're going to go to the airport north of us. I don't want to slow down too much. We need to keep power. So we've got a lot. I love this thing. This pattern, other pattern. The hill there. Basically, we're gonna go around the hill. Alright, so let's trim up. Oof, that's rough. So we trim up, we're gonna stay above this. I'm gonna bring the speed down once we make the turn here. Last part. Okay, going too fast. We're gonna slow down. We're going way too fast. Slow way down. Yeah. That seems more than 0.15 minutes. Okay, so we're gonna kind of go around this hill, above around. That's what we're gonna call it now. We're gonna drop our flaps down, so that should slow us down some. Yep. I acknowledge.
Clear to land runway 2 Crimson Romeo 666.
Yeah, see, I don't think we want to follow that pattern exactly, so it would be good if you don't. I think if you're flying this airport, I recommend you don't follow that pattern as it shows. You probably just want to come in to from the bay itself. We're coming in real fast, so we're going to drop the flaps all the way down again. Drop the engines down. Got a lot of wind. And back up. Okay. Rough. This one's rough. We got a lot of wind. They said 15 mile an hour winds. Microsoft Flight Simulator. Don't crash. I mean, if we crash, then I don't have to land it. Maybe, you know, it's fine. But, oh, we got plenty of runway. Look at that. Look how big that runway is. So we know that it's, that you're going to get pushed around. Good. We're fine with the wind. Speed up a little bit. Oh, good. I'm glad I'm clear. We got plenty of runway, so maybe this is the runway for large stall. Jets.
Stall. Stall.
We just beautiful.
Crest Tourist Golf Romeo 666, turn next taxiway.
Okie dokie. As soon as I see it. You can give me arrows. You can give me arrows too, so that's very nice. Very, very hilly.
Grim Tourist Golf Romeo 666 exit runway when able.
Yep. I'm able and I'm exiting. We just have grass. All right, that's fine. Yes, this is their taxiway. Grass.
Grim Tourist Golf Romeo 666 contact ground on 119.3.
Yep. Great. I will. Thank you. Appreciate it.
119.3 for Grim Tours Golf Romeo 666.
Request taxi to parking.
Ground Grim Tours Golf Romeo 666 taxi to parking.
Grim Tours Golf Romeo 666 taxi to general aviation parking.
I wonder if there would have been a better spot to park. No, thanks. To get off the runway, maybe there would have been a better. I don't know. I'm trying to go to where you said.
Taxiing to general aviation parking using taxiway, Grim Tours Golf Romeo 666.
Yep. Perfect. First try. Put the brakes on. And that's about it. So yeah, there you go. If you liked watching this, consider hitting that follow button, that like button, that subscribe button, all those buttons. Just hit them all, press them all at once, and make a comment at the same time. Tell me you did. I do this live on stream or on Twitch. I stream live. I'm doing great here at this exit. I stream live on Twitch at twitch.tv/ostriagrim, so you can check it out live when I do it. Playing Microsoft Flight Sim World Tour Tuesdays and Thursdays in the evenings. I do other games, checking out a game every week as far as how well it plays on the 1X player, which is like the Steam Deck, and then, you know, kind of just checking out other games as I go. And I'm going to be probably doing some more Minecraft here on Fridays, doing a Minecraft series, so keep an eye out for that. But yeah, that's about it. So we made a beautiful flight. How long did it take? Just over an hour to land and everything. So yeah, there we go. Again, if you liked it, you know, please consider that like button. If you haven't yet hit that like button, make a comment, let me know. You know, if I pronounced Providentia Bay incorrectly. Yeah, all that stuff. I guess that's it. Tell me how much you like or dislike the framing of the webcam too. Let me know if that's better. All that stuff. Anyways, as the weather, as the clouds roll in and all that stuff. yeah, that's about it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.